Maria del Pilar Miralles Castillo est l'une des finalistes du concours Île de Création. À cause de la pandémie, elle n'a malheureusement pas pu se rendre à la finale aujourd'hui, mais l'a suivie à distance. Elle s'est filmée depuis l'Académie Sibelius à Helsinki en Finlande, où elle étudie la composition. Je vous laisse découvrir ses motivations et la pièce qu'elle a écrite pour l'Orchestre National d'Île-de-France, Five Pieces of Advices.
The main reason was the given opportunity of writing for orchestra, which is quite rare and it is such a luxury, especially when you are still a student. Until now, I have never had the opportunity of listening to one of my pieces performed by a real orchestra. I have a lot of notes that I wrote down during the masterclass sessions with Guillaume Connesson. It was extremely helpful and interesting, and I got so many pieces of advice regarding the balances when it comes to composing for soloist and orchestra. The importance of the melodic component, and I especially remember a long talk about the aesthetical insights that somehow both of us share regarding the comprehension of today's language for the audience and the importance of the composer's sincerity. It was such a shame not to attend in person the final round because of the human component, and because the most important part for me about this experience is the contact with the real performers and the sharing process of my music to the players and eventually to the audience. So the composition process is eventually completed. The session with the soloist, with Victor Julian, was incredible, and he is such an outstanding performer, and it was so useful to get so close to the real instrument. Then meeting Guillaume Connesson was like a dream becoming true. Felt that I finally completed the communication process of one of the pieces I'm the most satisfied with in my yet short career. Such pieces of advice are the subtitles of the movements of my cello concerto. Those are stand up, close your eyes, walk, take a deep breath, and now you are ready. Those steps can be applied pretty much to any of our challenges, and for me it's obviously the composition process. I can also mention here one piece of advice given by my foremost reference in the composition, Brian, who is the composer Galina Uzbolskaya, and who replied to the question of what would you wish from a future composer, and she literally said, to write with great talent and bravery, so bravery and sincerity within an understandable language for the public you are writing for. The objective was to express myself in the most sincere way possible, and that is why the composition process is a challenge and why I need those steps that are my pieces of advice. Sometimes we need to use a language during competitions, applications, examinations, and so on. So in a way that we are sure that we will match the jury's or the professor's expectations. But we lose part of our own essence in such process. I think that in order to make contemporary music evolve, we need to focus on what should really be expressed and which language are we using to communicate ourselves with the performers and eventually with the audience. It was an actual challenge to match those requirements in order to compose an effective work with a whole coherence, because the movements are quite short and exact in their duration, and Therefore, my strategy was to use different characters in each movement, as well as different motivic material for each of them. But at the same time, I was reusing such characteristic material throughout all the other movements, applying their own mood and their own character. Well, my foremost wish is that my language is understandable by the public, and that brings about an emotional reaction in them. For me, the composition process has as its ultimate purpose to distort somehow the listener's perception of reality. I try to offer the listener through sound a different interpretation of the reality that we are sharing. And this eventually can contribute to the necessity of changing the state of such reality in case we are not satisfied with it. So music is eventually a tool for transforming reality and contributing to the evolution of societies.